Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to all Denarians on the go and in the know. Like, subscribe, and share with your fellow Denarian friends. To help support our channel, we now accept tips using the blockchain-based Brave browser and BAT tokens. It makes a huge difference and is very much appreciated. To those of you that made a contribution, I thank you. If you are interested in using the blockchain-based secure Brave browser, the link is in the description below. You can earn cryptocurrency as you surf the internet as you normally do. Ad blockers are in place to prevent all those unwanted bothersome ads, as well as your internet speed will increase significantly. I highly recommend it, as it is the only browser I will use on my desktop and phone. It was made by the same programmer that made the Firefox browser and is super secure and, as I stated earlier, based on the new blockchain technology of today. First article of interest for today. Government financial advisor. The implementation of the Iraqi-Chinese agreement is subject to approval of the budget and the end of China's isolation. The financial advisor to the Prime Minister, Mazhar Mohammad Saleh, confirmed that the implementation of the agreement concluded with China is subject to the approval of the general budget law for the fiscal year 2020 and the end of the Chinese economy's isolation. Saleh said in a press statement that the implementation of the Chinese agreement is subject to the legislation of the federal budget for the year 2020, noting that the agreement projects are an integral part of the general budget investment projects that require approval by the House of Representatives. He added that the continued isolation of the Chinese economy from the world to an unknown period may lead to stumbling the start of projects through what the agreement provides in terms of important implementation aspects through the role of Chinese companies in Iraq's strategic projects on the ground, noting that the problems related to the agreement are all pending on the data of the coming stage and the extent of its expansion, whether at the national level, the general budget legislation, or at the international level, and the lapse of China's isolation and its economy from the world. He pointed out that China consumes about 14 million barrels of oil per day and that more than half of it is imported, that is, about 8 million barrels of oil. It has temporarily reduced its demand for oil and by more than 22% of its daily needs due to the shrinking of economic activity, stressing that if it continues, global demand for oil decreases by about 20%. As a potential recession in international economic activity may happen because China represents the second largest economy in the world, whether in gross domestic product or global trade. Next article of interest. The Central achieved achievements in the payment system. The Central Bank of Iraq revealed achievements in payment systems in the payments department that included a group of hubs. He added in a bulletin on the central bank's website and followed by Al Sabah that the most important achievements in payment systems in the payments department in Iraq were represented by activating the IBAN, which means International Bank Account Number, on the payment system, RIGS-OC, which is defined as the International Bank Account Number and based on international special specifications. It is a special pattern of bank customer account numbers that allows its users to verify the validity of the account number transferred to it, and the banks were instructed to approve the unified IBAN in internal transfers as of 2 January 2017. International standards, he referred to, starting work to assess the readiness of the Iraqi payment system in line with international standards, FMIS, for the World Bank to improve payment and settlement systems in Iraq within the agreement with the World Bank, which deals with electronic payment systems in the country. He indicated that the mechanism of paying the salaries of employees of institutions and state departments has been reformed by localizing their salaries with bank accounts, and this bank is keen to meet all requirements to implement the process of localizing salaries in banks and converting the system of paying salaries to civil employees, including allocations and benefits, to a system electronic. Successful localization. He pointed out that it is in this sense that the Central Bank of Iraq, in cooperation with the banks, sought to bring this project into existence, and the success of the localization process for salaries and work has begun to localize the salaries of the bank's employees, so that the circular will be circulated to the rest of the ministries and all state departments during 2017. He continued, enhancing the role of payment systems and financial inclusion through digital services provided by banks and electronic payment services providers, as it represents an important dimension in the central strategy and automation of work through the use of electronic payment tools and encouraging the use of financial and banking services provided by banks and electronic payment services providers, and it supports small, medium and micro enterprises and facilitates their access to finance. In addition to activating electronic payment processes between ministries and government institutions, as well as evaluating banks and providers of electronic payment services technically, through the evaluation of technical aspects, electronic services and basic banking systems through which it is inferred at the level of banking efficiency in providing electronic services to customers. Next article of interest. Why Central Bank Digital Currencies Are the Killer App for Blockchain in 2020. With a global mobile payment market currently estimated at $816.50 billion and projections that it will reach over $5.5 trillion by 2025, the way we pay and transact money is about to change drastically. Judging by the buzz around central bank digital currencies, CBDCs, the likelihood that we will soon be spending and exchanging on a blockchain ledger are pretty high. Just this last month at the World Economic Forum annual meeting at Davos, one of the most discussed topics centered around CBDCs and how individual countries can issue, manage, govern and use digital currencies. We even had the former Commodity Futures Trading Commission Chairman J. Christopher Giancarlo announcing a new version of a digital dollar. The promise of central bank digital currencies, CBDCs, for regulated and compliant payments with faster settlement and increased liquidity management, comes at a time when the Bank of International Settlements estimates that over 80% of the central banks are looking at blockchain as a place to issue digital currencies. Just this last month, we heard that the central banks of Cambodia, Japan and the Bank of England are exploring the benefits of CBDCs. They have joined the long list of emerging markets and developed countries that have started working on digital currencies prototypes like Thailand, China, India, Sweden, Singapore and South Africa, out of which the emerging markets countries are more favorable in issuing and adoption a purely digital currency strategy than the developed countries, which currently face less issues. Even the European Central Bank, ECB, is researching how to digitize the euro. But what are the issues now? As we all know, most of the payments being made in the developed world are already digital per se. When we send money abroad, for example, we do not hold the cash in our hands. Rather, the funds are sent from a bank account and hence they are already digital. When we speak broadly about payment, we can generally identify two groups of transactions. One is bank-to-bank or wholesale, and the other is between individuals or retail. In both situations, we can clearly identify the current growing pains, such as availability of the funds, FX transactions fees, operational risks, settlement risks, visibility and traceability. For example, here are the main components of a cross-border transaction fee, which can be reduced with the introduction of a blockchain layer and a real-time gross settlement system, our TGS. Who will lead this digital transformation? In 2019, we saw the launch of Facebook Libra, which is an effort to solve some of the mentioned problems, but in fact the initiative faced a lot of scrutiny from regulators based on the level of trust they lack in the originating company Facebook. Apple, another giant technology company, has partnered with Goldman Sachs and issued its own credit card integrated into the popular iPhone, and again this effort faced questions around interest rates and diversity approval rates. At the other end of the spectrum are the central banks, which are generally more trusted than private enterprises when it comes to issuance of money and payments. For example, I see China as one of the first countries to adopt and implement a purely digital currency strategy. This will be a relatively easy task for a highly centralized country that already has an advanced payments infrastructure. In fact, China's mobile payments market is already controlled by Alipay and WeChat Pay, And with the help of the People's Bank of China, PBOC, that brings the top-down enforced digital currency electronic payment, DCEP, initiative, the country can easily deploy a wholesale CBDC. Why blockchain? Well, for a start, not all digital currencies or payment systems will need blockchain. For example, the Fed no real-time payment system might not have a blockchain component. Do not get confused. Central banks are not looking at any of the existing public blockchain as a viable option. Instead, they are all researching and testing or private and permissioned blockchain will fit their goals. A typical tiered enterprise architecture with blockchain at its core is perfectly fine of handling the load and throughput of such payment system. Adding a blockchain or another distributed ledger technology as a base component, the issuing bank can have all the benefits of token-based accounts like enhanced privacy, faster back-end reconciliation with fewer errors, funds predictability, end-to-end KYC and AML-enriched transactions with cheaper fees, all within a legally robust framework. One of the main benefits of the current cash money is that they are perfectly fungible. This can be achieved too with enough privacy for the end user with a calculated balance between transparency and privacy protection encoded into the core blockchain protocol. On top of that, with the introduction of widely accepted CBDCs, we can have even greater safety and insurance coverages from fraud and theft of our digital wallet funds. One thing is certain. In 2020 we will see a lot of activities around central bank digital currencies and their usage could be the de facto killer app for the blockchain technology. It's something that we have been looking at in the past and attributed to digital identities or voting systems, but they have proven to take longer to develop. Now, with China and the US in the digital currencies race, I am pretty sure that CBDCs can be the first production deployment at such a large scale for the blockchain technology. Hit the like and subscribe button to be alerted as more articles of interest are posted. Be sure to visit my Dinarian blog. Also check out my Facebook or Twitter for all of today's articles of interest as I post them on those platforms as well. Pick up your free trial copy of the newly upgraded currency exchange planner before you leave. Use the promo code, TheDinarian, and get 25% off at checkout when you decide to unleash the full planner's abilities, along with the mobile application added free for being my subscriber. Also be sure and register today as an affiliate with the Gold Savings Carrot Bar program. If you do not keep your savings in a real asset like gold, you risk everything as the fiat system fails and they boot up the new quantum financial system on the blockchain. Protect your family's wealth today in physical gold, as tomorrow may be too late. The program is made so everyone can afford to save in gold, by offering it 1 gram at a time. Start saving in a real true asset like gold. It's free to register and secure your family's savings tomorrow. Why do you think all the central banks loading up on gold lately, and running from the current depreciating fiat US dollar? Do you think they do not know what is coming? Get yourself protected today. Both of the links to these invaluable programs are available in the description box below this video. Go check them out. Knowledge is power. Using that newfound knowledge is powerful. Over and out, for now, the Dinarian.